On behalf of the teachers, staff, counselors, and administrators of Fulton High School, we all want to say again, congratulations to the Falcon graduates of 2020. Your perseverance in the face of adversity, your tenacity in getting your work completed, and the last 12 years of your lives are about to be celebrated here at Fulton High School on the Bob Black football field. And we are all so incredibly proud of you. We hope this short video will act as a rehearsal of sorts for your big day. If you have questions, feel free to email your SLC counselor or administrator, and we will do our best to help you. Students should park here in the lot just outside the gym. Your family members will be asked to park across the street to save room for all of you. Remember, each student gets 4 tickets, and each person attending graduation will need to be able to show his or her ticket at the gate. Please be at the school by 6 p.m. on June the 11th. Enter the gym through the lobby. Once inside, you will find tables set up with your SLC counselors. They have cards for you with your full name, and each card will also have a number. The cards are for Mr. Mays to read your name when you cross the stage, but the numbers are to help you line up in alphabetical order by SLC. You will also receive a final information form and a pencil. Only graduating seniors will be allowed in the gym. Family members should not accompany you. If you are a grad scholar, a National Honor Society member, or are graduating with honors and/or a distinction, or have received an industry certification, there will be a table prepared for you to pick up your stoles and cords at this time. Every student should have his or her gown, cap, and tassel. If you plan to decorate your cap, it will need to be approved by Mr. Smith while you're waiting in the gym. Remember that decorations should be in line with Knox County School's dress code. Inappropriate language, references to weapons or gangs, and the portrayal of drugs or drug paraphernalia are not appropriate. Once you receive your card, you will be directed to an area of the bleachers where you should sit and wait for us to begin lining up. While there, you will fill out the final information forms given to you. We will leave the gym in the following order. The top 10% students will lead us. Then, skilled professions will be led out by Mrs. Brunson. They will be followed by health science, led by Mr. Childers. And finally, communications will march, led by Mr. Wilkinson. And this is the order in which we will sit on the field. We will exit single file through the far end of the gym, down the hallway, and out the door into the coach's parking lot. Our procession should adhere to social distancing guidelines, so please do not bunch up near the person in front of you. Because we have a long walk, several stairs to get down, a very steep incline just before reaching the field, and an extremely soft ground under us, comfortable shoes are recommended. We know our senior girls especially would love to dress up in very formal attire, including high heels or stilettos, but we strongly advise against doing this. The likelihood that you could fall and injure yourself is high. Keep those shoes for pictures afterward, but for graduation itself, think about tennis shoes, sandals, flip-flops, or wedge heels. The gates at the field for family members will also open at 6 o'clock. They may enter through the gate at the top of the stadium on the home side, or at the entrance on St. Mary's Street. They may also choose to sit on the home or visitor side bleachers. They will not be allowed to stand on the field or be on the track. They must remain in the bleachers. Handicap seating is available at the top of the home side and along the front row of the home bleachers. Family members may sit together, but as groups, please adhere to the social distancing guidelines. Restrooms at both ends of the stands will be open, but concessions are closed and water fountains will be turned off. The front of the stage will be on the 15-yard line. The top 10% will be in the first row on the 20-yard line. We will have 10 rows of 22 chairs. Each row will be on a 5-yard line, and chairs will be 3 feet apart to adhere to social distancing guidelines. Coach Wright and Mrs. Roth will be at the ends of the rows to let you know when to stand and when to approach the stage. And even though it is a stressful time and your mind will be on getting across that stage, please make sure that you do not bunch up close to the stage. Keep your distance as much as possible. When you get to the stage, give your card to Mr. Mays. wait by his podium until your name is called out clearly and completely, and you may then cross the stage to receive your diploma. When you are crossing the stage, we need you to remember that your picture will be taken. Don't get in a big hurry. Each of the SLC administrators will hand you your diploma from across a table. Please stop and get your picture taken at that time. Mr. Smith will hand diplomas to the top 10% students. Because of the social distancing guidelines in place, we will not be shaking hands with you. When the ceremony is complete, our teachers will line up before you are dismissed. They will form two lines at the exit to the field, and we will exit in the same way we entered, with our top 10% leading the way, and your SLC administrator will join the front of each SLC group. And this last part is extremely important. As you exit, all students are expected to go back to the gym to pick up your diploma from your SLC counselor. However, if you are a student who wore a special stole or cord, you may meet your parents in the parking lot for pictures while wearing your honors. Do not take long. We have 30 minutes after graduation to get all students back into the gym, collect their diploma, take care of any lingering fees, and return the stoles and cords picked up beforehand. If you miss that 30-minute window, your diploma will be mailed to you at a later date. No diplomas will be issued to seniors unless they are clear of all debts and they have returned their Chromebook. Again, only students will be allowed in the gym. Once you are finished, please exit immediately through the lobby. We hope this has been helpful, and if you need to, feel free to watch it again. And then you can watch it again. Be sure and share this with your family so everyone is aware. We hope the day goes smoothly for everyone involved, and again, congratulations on a job well done.